Back in November 2023, there was news about Citrix leaving Hong Kong and China market. In case you don't know, Citrix software allows companies to remote control workstation, server, tablets, etc. They also provide virtual application and virtual desktops. Here is the question. If Citrix leaving Hong Kong and China, is there any other option for company to use for the new project? Here comes Apache Guacamole to the rescue. This video is trying to help you set up Guacamole as quick as possible, and is mainly separated into three main sections: Docker, VS Code, and Guacamole in Docker. So what exactly is Apache Guacamole? From its website, Apache Guacamole is a client-less remote desktop gateway. It supports protocols like VNC, RTP, and SSH. With the application installed in Linux, you can connect to Windows machines in your network using just the Chrome browser. In this tutorial, we are not going to install Guacamole from source into Linux. We're going to save time and use Docker, and use Docker image with Guacamole installed. But in order for the Docker image to run in your Windows desktop, you will first have to go to Docker desktop website, download the installer and install into your machine. Once Docker is installed and rebooted the machine, open Docker and carry on with the rest of the installation. If you don't already have VS Code installed, go ahead, download it and install it. There are multiple ways of controlling Docker engine, but the easiest way by far I found is using VS Code. Once your VS Code is installed, open it up, go to the extension section and search Docker. Then install the extension. Once finished installing, a new Docker extension will appear in your VS Code. Click onto the Docker extension icon. Then you see containers and images sections. In this video's description, I've included a docker-compose YAML file. Please download it and open it with your Visual Studio Code. Docker-compose file is basically a description or configuration file for defining and running multiple container applications. This simplifies the control of your entire application stack. For a working version of Guacamole, we need three containers: MySQL database, guacd daemon, and Guacamole web application. Here, virtual network. MySQL database. Guacamole daemon. And Guacamole web application. We can now run this script by right-click on your mouse and run the compose up command. It will automatically go to your GitHub website, download the necessary images. Since this is the first time we run this script, it doesn't have the MySQL database, guacd daemon, and Guacamole web application images. At the end of the download procedure, there's an error message saying terminated with exit code. And above it, there's also an error message saying external volume MySQL data not found. This is because in our compose script, we use external volume. The two of them are MySQL data and Guacamole volume. We should have it created in advance before running the script. So now all we have to do is to create the volume in Docker Desktop. Let's create my SQL data volume. Let's create Guacamole volume. Now that both volumes are created and you can see it in Docker Desktop, let's run Compose up again. All containers finally up and running. Wahey! If you go to Docker Desktop Containers section, you can also see it in here, the containers are up and running. Let's open the browser and check on Guacamole. Somehow it shows an error. This means the web application failed to load. Let's go to the terminal in VS Code and type the following command and check the Guacamole web application's log. Notice the guacamole underscore web in the command is the container name for the Guacamole web application. We immediately see the error, table guacamole underscore user doesn't exist. Luckily, this missing table can be obtained from within the Docker image. The database table's initialization script can be extracted with this command. I'll place this initialization script in the description below so that you don't have to extract them. Now, because this script is being extracted using Windows, there are some Unicode inside the script. We have to run this command to convert them to Unicode. The converter script is initdb-utf8.sql. I'll also place this file into the video description below. Let's get into the database container. Let's log into the database as root. Let's show the database, and you can see guacamole underscore db is there. Finally, we can execute the table's initialization script. Now that the tables are in the database, we can go back to the browser and try guacamole again. Yay, the application is finally working. Now we can try to log in using guacamole as username and password. Once you log in, the browser will ask you if you allow the clipboard copy and paste feature. Just click allow because you would want to copy and paste text from your desktop into the remote desktop session through the browser. If you click onto guacamole settings, you see other features of the guacamole web application. I'll explain more about the guacamole web application features and how to connect to remote desktop session in my next video. If you enjoyed this video, do click like and subscribe so that you will be notified when my next video comes out. Thanks very much for watching.